that.
And then you just
you're part of no.
I
don't
do
clean yourself.
I will find out where you live. I will find you.
My name's Eloise Whitmore, and I am a sound designer / sound engineer. A sound engineer records the acoustics or the dialogue for radio or film or television or animation, and then I edit in post-production. So I take the recordings and I will add to the speech that we've recorded. I will add the wild tracks, which is the backgrounds, like skyline, birds, wind, and then any effects we might need, like dogs barking, doors closing, and also the music. So basically it's recording all the sound, putting it all together. I was interested in sound as an A-level student and radio, and joined a course that was run by my local council at a recording studio, learning how to basically mic up a drum kit, mic up a band and record an EQ. That went on to degree level, and then I got a job at the BBC. Physics and maths is very, very important for being a sound engineer. I could have made more use of going down a physics-maths route, especially understanding EQ. So I'd say physics and maths is very, very important.
Like me.
Boys! Jacob! Elijah! Stay close to me!
Come on!
The first thing you need to be a sound engineer is you need a really good pair of ears. My sight is terrible, but I have very, very acute hearing. I was on the tube yesterday. It was a really noisy tube, so I probably looked stupid, but I had my hands in my ears because they earn me my living, basically, so I can't afford to lose my hearing. You also need to be able to move silently, so a good pair of silent trainers is essential. This is page 4-6, take 1, action. I get really excited when I get the scripts and I see there's something exciting that needs to be recorded. Once we were recording a play about a hurdler, so I went to a track and mic'd myself up and ran around hurdling. And what you're recreating is the breathing, because you don't get that just running on the spot or pretending to breathe. You need the physical movement to actually get the breathing. Sound design or sound engineering is DIY. My favourite is the sick effect, which always entertains children, which is vegetable soup in a hot water bottle. And as the actor pretends to throw up, you press it to your chest and it all splats on the floor.
And there was me, drooling, drunk, and about to pu-
It was going in the wash anyway. Don't mention.
I tend to go wherever the play's set. I'm a great believer that the studio sounds too dead and sounds too much like a studio. So if the play is set in a swimming pool, I insist to the producer that we go to the swimming pool. This is just not something we could recreate in studio, so that's why I insisted on going to the swimming pool.
Did you get it?
I don't know.
What did you think I was saying?
I don't know.
Did you get anywhere at all?
Oh, what were you saying then?
Red lorry.